In science lecture, lesson 3, metals and non-metals. In today lecture, as you are able to see the photograph, that the periodic table is there, and we are able to see the blue color substance which are present. Here are all metals which are on the left side of the periodic table. On the right side of the periodic table, the yellow color substances after the borderline of an orange line that is made between two parts. These are generally non-metals or metalloids, some of them are. So, we divide the periodic table in two parts, that is metals and non-metals. In initial phase also, we identify the substances in the form of either metals or either in the form of a non-metals only, right. So, in this particular lecture, we are able to understand about the different properties of metals and non-metals. In different properties of non-metals and metals, first we will start with the physical properties of metals and non-metals. In that, first is hardness and state of matter. In hardness and state of matter, first of all we will start with metals, and in opposite, as a difference, we will start with non-metals. Metals are hard and are found in generally solid state. Exception is there is mercury. So, mercury is found in the liquid state at room temperature itself only, as you are seeing in thermometers and all. And otherwise, you may see other elements as an hardness. If you see alkyl elements, lithium, sodium, potassium, metals are soft metals, and they can be cut in the form of with the help of a knife. In the form of a knife, we can cut out these particular metals, that is sodium, potassium and all. In case of non-metals, they are weaker than compared to that of a metals in state of matter, and found in all states, that is as an hardness they are weaker, but they are found in all states of matter, that is they are found in solid state also, liquid state also and gaseous state also. There is an exception in case of an hardness, that is diamond allotrope of a carbon. Diamond allotrope of a carbon is a few hardest substance found in the nature, fine. So, this is a few hardest substance found in the nature. Then we will start with the second point, that is melting point and boiling point. In melting point and boiling point of the substance, we see that melting and boiling points of the metals are always in the higher form. This is an higher state of matter, that is boiling and melting points are quite high compared to that of the non-metals. In case of non-metals, obviously they are lower compared to that of metals. But there are certain exceptions as far as melting and boiling points are concerned, like gallium and cesium. They melt it down at very low temperature, right? That you keep it in your palm and your hand, these particular elements, they melt down at something 300 degrees Celsius odd around. That means Kelvin odd around. That means 300 Kelvin is something around 27 degrees Celsius or above. So, at 27 to 30 degrees Celsius, this substance start melting down, and you don't find furthermore them into solid state, fine. So, in the temperature like Ahmedabad, at normal temperature is above 30 only, so you will never find these substances into solid state. Now, in case of non-metals, the boiling points and melting points are high, but not that high as compared to that of the metals. The diamond and carbon, diamond that is an allotrope of carbon, is having an higher melting and boiling point. The next is an lustrousness. Lustrous is shining. So, maximum of the metals are quite shining by the nature, right. We use the shining at different purposes also, like chromium and all, aluminium, chromium for showing show metals. Other than the non-metals are not having any kind of shining or lustrous phase. Except iodine, you find that it's a brownish violet kind of substance, you find it is quite lustrous by its nature. So, that is an exception in case of a non-metal. Then is sonorous, the sound. The sound is particular, the sound of the metals are ringing sound, that is a sonorous sound is found in case of an metals. If you sometimes we go in the night for drinking water, and by mistake we drop the glass, steel glass from our hand, and that sound, that ringing sound is found in the entire room, and we find very annoying that also. So, this particular ringing sound is found very frequently by the metals. The metal that has been ringing as a bell in your schools, So that is another ringing sound that can be explained. Generally, we see any sound made by metals only. Non-metals do not produce any kind of sound by striking. Then comes the point of malleability. Now, malleability is an ability to prepare thin sheets. Whatever the sheets that we find, like copper, silver, gold, whatever the sheet metals, that means that's a kind of a thin film that is found of iron. Many of the metals are generally found in the form of metals in our general life, in daily life. Fine. So gold and silver is general malleable metals that they are the one of the finest malleable metals, I would say. That is the most malleability is found in gold and silver. The non-metals are not malleable, cannot be formed in the thin sheets. So this particular non-metal do not have on striking, that you go on striking and it form in the form of an sheets. Fine, it is not possible in case of a non-metals. Now ductility, that is an ability to draw wire. To draw wire, that means copper wire, and generally the wires that we have seen, they are generally metal pieces. They are fixed and pull out of a die. It forms in the form of an wire. That's an capability of pulling and making the atom configuration into the circular form, in the cylindrical form rather. So that is an ability to draw in the form of an wires. So they have the ability to draw in the fire wires, that is called as an ductility. The gold is one of the most ductile metal, that one only a single gram of gold can be turned to a 2 kilometer long wire, that is 2,000 meters. That's a very 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 long thing that can be pulled upon. Ductility is not found in non-metals, so they do not show any kind of ductility. Now, as in heat conductivity, the conductivity of heat in case of an metals, though generally they are good conductor of heat and electricity, generally they are good conductor of heat. In case of copper, silver are the best heat conductors that we are found that we using as in vessels also. Silver wires are also used, but less in quantity because they are very costly. But generally, we use copper wires in the as an good conductor of in heat. Fine, copper is a good conductor. So we see the plating on the steel vessels, and the below side is made up of copper only, so that it conducts the heat very fast and passes to the silver. Non-metals are the poor conductor of heat. In case of electricity conductivity, in case of conductivity of heat, lead and mercury are the poor conductors of heat. Fine, so they are an exception as in heat conductivity. In case of metals, they conduct heat, but they are very poor in conductivity. That's why wherever the lead is there, they do not pass heat energy very easily. Now, in case of conductivity, that is electrical conductivity, we find they are very metals are very good conductor of electricity. The silver is the best conductor of electricity. Then comes the number of copper, and then aluminum, and so on, because the resistivity is very less. In case of conductivity in non-metals, they are poor conductor of electricity. But in case of carbon allotrope, that is graphite, we see that it shows it's found as a semiconductor. That means it is not a very good conductor, but it is a semiconductor. But then also it is a good conductor of it is found as a good conductor of electricity in case of non-metals. Lastly, the examples, as we have spoken many, gold, silver, iron, copper, aluminum, lead, mercury, etc., are the examples of metals. In case of non-metals, oxygen, nitrogen, helium, sulfur, phosphorus, and chlorine, fluorine, bromine, iodine, many gases are also there. Many solid particles are also there, many liquid particles are also there, like bromine is in the case of a non-metal, is in the form of a liquid. So these are the different non-metals and metals found in the and their physical properties also. So thank you for this particular video.